Thank you. I'd be happy to. Is there anything special you want me to say?
Gosh, let me think. Well, why don't you start it out, Dear Vicky. That's V-I-C, just an I. V-I-C-K-I. Dear Vicky. You are my favorite actress. You are my favorite actress. And the best talk show host. And the best...
Host?
Hostess. The best talk show hostess. The best...
And the...
Best.
Best. Underlined.
Talk show.
Talk.
Show hostess.
Show. Hostess.
Oh, put. I love the way you look. I love the way you look. Put that.
I love the way you look.
I love the way you look. Put that there.
I love the way you look.
I love your hair. But I love your hair. I love your hair.
I love your hair.
I love your hair.
I love your hair. Now, how do you want me to sign this?
Well, I don't care. It's your autograph. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the one and only Bill Burr. Have a seat. I'll treasure this always, and I know exactly who that X is from.
I have it bronzed for you.
So listen, big guy, you got turned away at the NBC gate coming in tonight, huh?
Yes, they wouldn't let him in.
They would not let him in. Do you love it? This happened to me one day. I was coming in, and it was 20 minutes, and they kept going through the thing, and I'm sorry, but we just don't have clearance for you. And I said, well, I thought maybe they put it under my married name. So I said, well, will you look under Schultz? They said, oh, you're Vicki Lawrence. We've been looking under Carol Burnett. But now, please, Ironside and Perry Mason are both on NBC.
Yes.
Well, I want you to know that I brought you a little gift. This is a temporary visitor's pass. We had it. It's done by the official guard gates out there. There. So you're cleared here. It says Raymond Burke. Cleared to NBC.
Says Godzilla on it.
Today only.
Today only.
Yeah, you're out of here after today. You're like one of my favorite bad guys in the movies. You were a bad guy in everything that I remember.
Like, I wish you'd rephrase that.
Well, like Rear Window. Ooh.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah, Place in the Sun.
All right.
Tarzan. How about Godzilla?
Godzilla.
I didn't even know you did Godzilla.
I did Godzilla twice, 30 years apart.
Well, guess what? We have a clip of Godzilla.
You're kidding.
Yeah, we just thought that would be kind of a special thing. You know, since you're such a wonderful, legendary actor, we wanted to pick a meaningful piece of your work for everyone to...
Thank you very much.
Here's a trailer from Godzilla. Ladies and gentlemen.
Godzilla, king of the monsters, alive, surging up from the depths of the sea on a tidal wave of terror. You may wish to deny it, but your eyes tell you it's true. A tale to stun the mind. Awesome. Incredible. Unbelievable. A story beyond your wildest dreams. Dynamic violence. Savage action. Spectacular thrills. Godzilla, king of the monsters.
I was very fond of Godzilla.
I could see you were and horrified of him. How do you get from being mostly bad guys to being like one of the most revered people in television? How did that happen? You have no idea. But Perry Mason, when did Perry Mason happen? Was that the first that was like the first television deal, long run?
Well, it was, yes, we did the pilot in 56 and started on the air. People were still buying television sets for the, first time.
Yeah.
And we started on the air in 57.
Did you, how long did that thing run? Forever, 300
years.
Episodes you guys did, right?
9 years, yes.
And Did you ever study law at all?
Not after I started doing the show.
Did you have like a technical advisor or something?
Oh, sure.
We had Mr. Mason.
We had Mr. Gardner, who wrote Perry Mason.
Right.
And we had a lawyer by the name of Mason.
Really?
And we had a producer by the name of Mason. So there were a lot of Masons around.
Yeah. So you probably know more about law than you really ever wanted to know.
I know enough to hire a very good lawyer in case I'm in trouble.
That's a good deal. You know, I always tell people if they're going to go into this business that they should major in law or business and minor in abnormal psychology.
Yeah, start when they're about 6 years of age.
Yeah.
Then they're maybe ready to be an actor or an actress.
Did you ever have people come up to you and ask you legal advice?
Of course.
What do they ask you?
How to get out of jail. How to stay out of jail. How not to go to jail.
Oh, stop it. I didn't know. You know, I made one measly little trip to Vietnam. You made 30 trips, did you, to Korea and Vietnam?
How 14 many to Vietnam and 18 to Korea.
Wow. What prompted all of that?
Everybody asks that, or used to ask that question. I think it's because all of us that we were fond of were there. All the young people were there. And we should, you know, go and pay attention to them.
Yeah, but that's a lot of going and a lot of...
Yeah, it was. It was.
A lot of...
But once you... Yeah, I started doing shows in Korea and Vietnam, which weren't really shows. They were just handshake tours.
Yeah. That's what we did.
Yeah, I started that kind of thing.
Because
our defense posture changed in Korea. We had 300 or 400 people on tops of mountains, and they couldn't get down to see a show,
right.
And we couldn't get up to see them. So you'd fly up on a helicopter.
I like those better, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Because you really got to see
just sit around and shoot the breeze, talk about hometown.
Absolutely. What are you... You're writing a book now?
I am writing... three books.
At once?
Well, from time to time. I'm doing a cookbook with a young lady by the name of Elka Gilmore in San Francisco, and she's a marvelous young chef.
You like to cook then, huh?
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
And doing a biography of the, autobiography of the television years only. All the stuff that comes up to them.
Yes.
I'm waiting for a second book. And then I'm going to do a book on the tabloids.
You're going to do a book on the tabloids?
Somebody ought
to. You're going to turn the tables, are you?
No, it's not turning the tables, but nobody's really written about the tabloids, and I think it's about time to do it.
And what, how they operate, or?
You have to get the book.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you've had your trials
Have great knowledge of a number of people close to you, and I hope I'm one of them, that have been, the tabloids have me dead 12 times over.
Yes. You're well, by the way.
I'm in very good shape.
Good.
Best I've been in 20 years.
Good for you.
Yeah.
Good. Ironside is, this is the first reunion in how many years?
Well, we finished the picture.
Right. 20 years, is it?
We finished doing the show around 74, 75. We started in 1966 and then went 9 years.
What was it like getting together with everybody again?
We have not been separate. Don Galloway is one of my best friends. And it's like Barbara Hale. I wait until their children are growing up and then I go on to somebody else.
No, but you know, like Carol and I are really good friends, but it's not, people think in this town that you see each other at the gas station every day or at the market, and it's just not so. Most of the time you see each other at functions, or it's hard getting together. And when we got together for the reunion, it was like we had never been apart. Work, and I'm talking about in the working.
Oh, yeah, that was so great when Barbara and I did the first Perry Mason 2-hour movie. Why? We usually do the courtroom last. But in this one, we started with a courtroom, so there we hadn't done any shows together. We had done shows together, but not Perry Mason. We sat down in the courtroom, And it was one of the greatest experiences of your life because you immediately took 25 years off.
Yeah.
And it was great. And she's wonderful to work with.
Yeah. We're going to bring out the cast, some of the folks who have been reunited to work together again for the first time for the upcoming NBC special, The Return of Ironside, which is going to air on Tuesday, May 4th. Please welcome Elizabeth Bauer, Don Galloway, and Don Mitchell.
Yay.
Good to see you.